Welcome to a new video from EU Droneport. When flying a drone, the EU regulations categorize drones based on their purpose and potential risks. In the open category, drones must fly within the visual line of sight and below 120 meters in altitude. Exceptions to exceed this limit are rare, such as when granted permission by an owner of an obstacle taller than 105 meters for specific aerial work, allowing a 15-meter increase above the obstacle. However, Class 0 drones cannot benefit from surpassing these altitude limits. This category has specific restrictions, preventing exceptions like those allowed for other drones in the open category. Since manned aircraft usually fly above 150 meters, there is a much greater chance of coming across one above 120 meters. A safety margin of 30 meters has been added. As a result, 120 meters must be the maximum operating distance for the open category. However, as previously stated, the 120 meter altitude limit can be unlocked under extremely specific conditions. Drones that are small in size, weighing no more than 250 grams, come in a wide range of designs and applications. While some of these devices, like the DJI Mini model and related drones, might be considered toys, others might be examples of cutting-edge technology. According to safety assessments, people are not at great risk from drones operating at speeds below 19 meters per second. There is, however, cause for concern when these drones come into contact with airplanes, particularly tiny ones or aircraft that are lighter than air, like hot air balloons. Under such conditions, even a tiny drone could be extremely dangerous. Therefore, in the open subcategory A1, a significant simplification was introduced in the operation of C0 drones. No training is required for remote pilots. Geo-awareness is not mandatory. And remote identification is not necessary. This is a significant simplification. However, these amenities are counterbalanced by more stringent operating guidelines, like the 120 meter height restriction. Accidents may result from allowing remote pilots to use C0 drones to fly higher without realizing the possible risks, as covered in the A1, A3 online training. Moreover, a 250 grams drone is typically quite small and might not be noticeable from a distance of more than a few dozen meters, which would make it difficult to maintain VLOS. The drone would be invisible at 120 meters, which would be extremely dangerous. However, nothing stops a manufacturer from designating a drone weighing less than 250 grams as C1. In this scenario, in order to unlock the 120 meter limit, remote pilots will have to finish an online training course. Drone pilots must undergo this simple but crucial training to make sure they understand their responsibilities and the risks they may pose to other users of airspace. For more information regarding 120 meter height limit for C0 drones, visit eudroneport.com or click the link in the description. Safe flights.